Hi. I think I'll do a, try and do a Rocky stream with lots of rocks in the water. Quite a dramatic landscape. I'll wet the paper all over. Be nice and wet. So Fabriano, 130-pound weight. I haven't done a drawing, I'm going to go straight in with a picture. Or try to. Right, I'll put a bit of raw sienna. A simple sky for this. I'm going to do some tumbling landscape here. Good amount of raw sienna. Get all over. And then over that, I'll go with some blue, but not too heavy. It's just going to be a background. And where we have the stream, okay, that will do. Right. Well, that's going to dry off. As it does so, the water will expand the paper, so we'll just reclip it. That'll do. Nice and flat. I'll wait for that to dry off a little bit. I'll explain my paints if you don't know. There's lemon yellow, dirty lemon yellow, raw sienna, alizarin crimson, light red, ultramarine, burnt umber, Payne's grey, and burnt sienna. The paints are dry, but as you work on them with water, they soften and you can get some lovely, it's great putting really thick, juicy paint into a wet wash. It's more or less stays where you put it, but it has some, does some wonderful things. That's not quite, let's just get that there. Oops. Right, let's put in a background. A bit of greeny burnt sienna. I like burnt sienna. Right, let's have a good... I'm going to put some darker colours in there. And I want this quite dark because I want to scrape out where the rocks are, some of this. I'm mixing light red, ultramarine, sienna. That's in the water. Right, let's just get some more. I'm going to go over the card in a second. But you need to get the dark colours in with the water. The other side to do. I'll just roughly get that in. That's quite light. It's a bit sienna-y. Bit of lemon yellow in there. Then we've got some rocks in there. These are the shadows I'm putting in before it's. Before I scrape out, but I'm trying to keep all this nice and wet. But that's where I want my darks in here. Okay, let's see what we can do with that. So we've got. Something there like that. I can always put in the dark planes with the brush afterwards. Let's just show that. Need a bit of imagination on this. Some over here. Right, a little bit in here. Okay, bit of a background now. Here we've got, I tried to dry brush that, but that's not working, but we've got the shadow, or the reflections coming down this. Right, okay, so we want a bit of a blue background. A little bit of sienna in there, burnt sienna, as you say. And let's just put something to do for trees and. And a bit darker in the base here. Nice rich paint in there on the blue side. Oops, a bit too sloppy. Now I'll put in some darker green texture in this. I'll put some trees on this. More sienna. nights and darks, and Emma seems to be dry brushing okay there. Right, now I'm just going to thicken up the shadow on those rocks. So there we are, we've put some texture back in there. Let's just carve a little bit out here. There. Okay, that'll do for that. Now I'm going to just drop in some burnt sienna and ultramarine. I'm going to put in, I want this really thick. So you can see my paints, so the blue is soft, the sienna, burnt sienna, is very, very soft. So I can go with some darker bits of grass. Oops, I mean darker. I don't want to look too mechanical with the surface of the paper, but that's exactly what's happened. But I'm going to put some trees on this and just texture over there. Now there's some light in the top of this river there. Tumbling stream. I'll put that in. And when that's dry, I'm going to try to dry brush a little bit of darker blue over to show a bit of tumbly stuff. So let's get in with some trees now. Same colours. This is a very limited palette. Well, fairly limited. I'm using the ultramarine, light red, burnt sienna, lemon yellow, a little bit of that, and the raw sienna as well. So we're one fairly, right, let's get that, get one up here. Light one side. And there. Just an impression of trees. I'm not making any great portraits of them, just creating an impression. I'll put in some rigger stuff as well. And we've got some coming up here. More blue as we go behind there. Remember, cool colours recede and warmer colours come forward, draw your eye forward. And we've got these coming up here. I'll put some twigs and branches on these, but only just a bit of lost and found detail, really. That was, I'll just use to soften the tops of those. Okay, now a bit of harder stuff in there. That'll have the, hopefully have the effect of moving that back further and making that light bit there a bit lighter. Right, then we'll put some trees on the other side. I'm working from an old photograph. I'm not going to show you. I'm just making it up really, just using it as a guide. I will have some dark in there. Thicken that up there. They're using the sienna, the burnt sienna. This, I'm separating these trees from the background trees. Right, okay, let's put in some darker green using those colours, lemon yellow, blue and the brown of the sienna. So let's just some sort of pines in here somewhere. While that's drying off and I think about what I'm going to do with the rigger, I'm just going to use a bit of my clean palette, a little bit, and use just pure blue just have a bit of right, let that dry, then I'm going to see if I can dry brush a little bit of shadow, a bit of reflection, broken reflection on that. Right, bit of rigger stuff now. Not a lot, just a bit of, just using the blue and the brown. When I say brown, I mean burnt sienna. Because there's lots of little branches still sticking out from trees and when you use a rigger like this, you need a lot of water. That one I'm trying to show go behind. I shouldn't have put it in really, but I did. So I can't do much about that. Right, okay, I'll give that a bit of a... maybe some... fill up there and get that dark on one side. Right, okay, I'll let that go. I'm going to give that a bit of a dry, so if you're listening, take your headphones off right now. Now, I can only really do this with a hake, so I'm just going to use some darker dry brush here. Oh, I don't know what I've done there. Oh. Put that as a bit of a heavier reflection of that tree there. Right, that's the best I can do with that one. I'm going to sign it and put it in a mount. And also, I'm going to start... sign it here. That's me. I painted this picture. Bit of a problem. I've tried to find out ways to safeguard my paintings, my demos from being taken If anybody's watched the video of Paul Taggart, great artist and demonstrator, who's had some of his videos stolen and republished on another website. So what I'm going to do, I'll find my little pen, I'm going to write copyright C. Dave Usher, September 2014. That'll be behind the mount. So can you see that? Let's zoom you in down to there. Now, I've written my copyright, that's my copyright. I painted this picture and did this demo. It's a shame I'm going to do that, but I would hate to get all my work cloned or probably uploaded on someone else's channel and they get the benefit of it. So there we are. So there we are. I can put that up a little bit. But anyway, there we are. Burbage Brook, Derbyshire, in the Dales. Not the Dales, in the Peak District. As good as I can do with the brush and the paper with the direction of the tumbling stuff. But anyway, I've tried to get the shadow, the three planes on the rocks, as simply as I can. Have a go, see what you come up with. Let's, it looks right on the screen. Let's go back and have a little look. Oh, there's my background. And there are my rocks, quite big. Not so they're particularly good, but not a bad picture. Hope you enjoyed that. Thanks for watching. Whoops. I'll let you look at it for a few seconds. Goodbye.